morning to all of you. Already we have started game playing. So in the last lecture we have seen how we are going to make the moves so that the machine should work intelligently. Now we are going to start with the optimal decision in the games. Now when we optimal decisions, we have to take best decision in the games. So suppose there are two or three possibilities, what will be the best possibility so that the machine should be a winner? So in that that point of view we have to think, and that is called as optimal decisions. Optimal decision म्हणजे काय की समजा आपल्याकडे दोन तीन ऑप्शन्स असतील तर कोणता ऑप्शन हा बेस्ट असणार आहे की जेणेकरून मशीन हे विनर होणार आहे, तर त्याला म्हणतो आपण ऑप्टिमल डिसिजन इन द गेम्स. सो द बेस्ट डिसिजन विच कॅन टेक दॅट इन द गेम, दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज ऑप्टिमल डिसिजन्स. सो इन द नॉर्मल सर्च प्रॉब्लेम द ऑप्टिमल सोल्युशन वुड बी अ सिक्वेन्स ऑफ ॲक्शन लिडिंग टू अ गोल स्टेट द टर्मिनल स्टेट दॅट इज अ विन. म्हणजेच ऑप्टिमल डिसिजन ही आपली अशी डिसिजन असली पाहिजे की द अल्टिमेट गोल जो आपला आहे तो म्हणजे विनिंगचा, तो विनिंगचा गोल अचीव होण्यासाठीचा सिक्वेन्स असला पाहिजे. सो द ऑप्टिमल सोल्युशन वुड बी द सिक्वेन्स ऑफ ॲक्शन्स. सो इट इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ सिक्वेन्स ऑफ ॲक्शन्स लिडिंग टू द गोल स्टेट. सो देर इज वन इनिशियल स्टेट अँड देर इज वन गोल स्टेट. गोल स्टेट इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ फायनल स्टेट, अँड इनिशियल मीन्स स्टार्टिंग स्टेट. सो द गोल स्टेट शुड बी द विनिंग स्टेट ऑफ द मशीन. सो इन दॅट पॉईंट ऑफ व्ह्यू वी हॅव टू थिंक अँड वी हॅव टू टेक दॅट डिसिजन्स, अँड दॅट इज ऑप्टिमल डिसिजन्स. इन ॲडवर्सरियल सर्च द मेन हॅज समथिंग टू से अबाउट इट. द मॅक्स देअरफॉर मस्ट फाईंड अ कॉन्टिजंट स्ट्रॅटेजी विच स्पेसिफाईज मॅक्स मूव इन द इनिशियल स्टेट, देन मॅक्स मूव इन द स्टेट रिझल्टिंग फ्रॉम एव्हरी पॉसिबल रिस्पॉन्स बाय मेन. Then max move in the state resulting from every possible response by min to those moves and so on. So suppose the max has started or the min has started. Now suppose the min has started and it has taken one step, then the step of the max should be in such a way that the max should think that he is going to win the game. So in that way we have to think. So min is something to say about it, means min has started the game and min has placed his symbol at anywhere. Now the max is therefore must find a contingent strategy. So the max should find a strategy in such a way that the max move in the initial state, the max move in the state resulting from every possible response by min. So max should be in such a position that he has to think what will be the next position of the min, and accordingly he has to take the decision. So suppose samja min ne sar suruvat keli asel game play sathi, tyanantar max ha play karnar aahe, pan max play karaycha agodar min chi tyanantar chi step ka asu shakte and tyacha anusar max chi konti decision asayla pahije kiwa max cha konta move asayla pahije tyachi decision, that is called as optimal decision. So the optimal decision is a decision which is going to take the game into a winning state or the goal state. So the max moves in the state resulting from every possible response by min to those moves, and that way we have to take the optimal decisions. An optimal strategy leads to outcomes at least as good as any other strategy when one is playing an infallible opponent. Now we begin by showing how to find this optimal strategy. Even a simple game like a tic-tac-toe is too complex for us to draw the entire game tree on a one page. So we will switch to its travel game as shown in the figure. The possible moves for max at the root node are labeled as A1, A2, A3. The possible replies to A1 for the min are B1, B2, B3 and so on. So we have to think about the possible moves, and possible moves should be labeled. So if it is in the first row, it can be A1, A2, A3. If it is in the second row, it can be B1, B2, B3. If it is in the third row, it can be C1, C2, C3. So like this, we have to think what will be the next label. This particular game ends after one move each by max and min. The utilities for play, that is PLY, the terminal state in this game range from 2 to 14. Now this is the max and this is the min. Now the possible moves can be A1, A2, A3 or the B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So like this we have to think what are the possible moves. It is a 2 player game tree, that means it is going to be played by 2 players. Now this symbol nodes are the for the max nodes, in which it is a max turn to move, and this symbol nodes are min nodes. The terminal nodes show the utility values for max, and the other nodes are labeled with their minimax values. Max based move adder route is A1 because it leads to the state with the highest minimax value, and min's best reply is B1 because it leads to the state with the lowest minimax value. So suppose the max has taken the first row or the first position, that means the first column box, so that will be the position of the, that will be the A1 position, and that will be the position of the max. Then the move of the min position will be at a A2 position or at the A3 position. So like this the possibility can be at the A2 or A3. So like this we have to think and we have to apply it. Given a game tree, the optimal strategy can be determined from the minimax value for each node, which you can write as minimax of n. So n possibilities are there. The minimax value of a node is the utility of being in the corresponding state, assuming that both players play optimally from their end-to-end game. So we have to calculate minimax position. So when we are going to calculate this minimax position, we have to think that both players are taking best of the best decision, that is called as optimal decisions, and accordingly we have to think and accordingly we have to give the inputs. The minimax value of a terminal state is just utility. Given a choice, max prefers to move to the state of a maximum value, whereas min prefers a state of a minimum value. So we have the following equations. So minimax of S, we have to calculate this minimax of S. Utility of S if terminal state is S. Now max A belongs to actions of S. Minimax of result will be S and A if player is max, and min A belongs to actions of S, minimax results S of A if player belongs to min. So that will be the equations we can calculate how the max belongs to and how the min belongs to. So max have the maximum positions and min have the minimum positions. Now let's apply these definitions to the game tree of the above figure. The terminal nodes on the bottom level gets their utility values from the game's utility function. Now already we know what is meant by utility function. The first min node labeled B has three successor states with a value 3, 12 and 8. So its minimax value will be 3 because that will be the minimum value. Similarly, the other two min nodes have the minimax value of 2. The root node is a max node, its successor state have minimax value 3, 2 and 2. So its minimax value of 3. That means minimax value means nothing but it is the lowest value out of the 3 values. We can also identify the minimax decision of that root. Action A1 is the optimal choice for max because it leads to the state with the highest minimax value. So this was about the how we are going to take the optimal decisions. So while taking the optimal decisions, we have to take consideration that both the players are in a strong, and we have to think best of the best for both the players. Next we are going to think how we are going to calculate this minimax value, and this is the algorithm. The algorithm is called as minimax algorithm. We have to find out the minimum value out of the 3 possible values. The minimax algorithm computes the minimax decision from the current state. So the min-max decision total depends on the position or the current state of the player. It uses a simple recursive computation of the min-max values for each successor state, directly implementing the defining equations. The recursion proceeds all the way down to the leaves of the tree, and then the min-max values are backed up through the tree as the recursive unwinds. So here we have to use a tree implementation, and by using this tree implementation, we have to implement min-max algorithm. For example, in above figure, the algorithm first recurses down to the three bottom left nodes. So recursively first it is going to take three positions of the left node, uses a function on them to discover that their values are 3, 12 and 8. Then it takes the minimum of the value, that is 3, and returns it to the backed up value of the node B. A similar process gives up the backed up values of 2 for C and 2 for D. Finally, we take the maximum of 3, 2 and 2 to get the backed up value of 3 for the root node. The min-max algorithm performs a complete depth-first exploration of the game tree. So here, depth-first search is used for the exploration of min-max algorithm. If the maximum depth of the tree is M and there are B legal moves at each point, then the time complexity of the min-max algorithm is order of B raised to M. So here, in the last session also we have seen that if there are nodes, the nodes are the states or the positions, and the edges are the decisions we have to take. So that tree like a structure we have used when we are going to calculate the minimax value, that is called as minimax algorithm. So the tree like structure is implemented, and the tree traversal will be depth first search. So according to depth first search, we have applied for the minimax algorithm. The space complexity, order of B raised to M, for an algorithm that regenerates all the actions at once, because that will be only one action and all the actions will be generated, but out of the all the actions only one action will be carried out. So O of M for the algorithm that generates actions one at a time, because there will be one move in the above game, but there will be more number of possibilities. So all the possibilities will be generated, and out of the all possibilities only one step will be taken, and that will be the optimal decision. So that was the end of the today's session. We have seen how the optimal search is found out and how the minimax algorithm is applied. Basically, minimax algorithm is nothing but depth first search, and which is going to take the optimal decision. So if you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.